everybody. Welcome to my channel, Dare to Study. This is part 2 of chapter Conventional Source of Energy. In first part, we read about coal. In this part, we are going to read about petroleum. So, petroleum itself comes from two words. That is petra, which means rock, okay, and the other word is oleum, which means oil. Therefore, petroleum is also known as rock oil, the oil which is obtained from the rocks below the earth's crust, okay. That is what petroleum actually means. Now, see, it also has a special adjective. We give a special adjective to petroleum, and that is liquid gold. Liquid gold. We all know that gold is a very precious metal, isn't it? So, why do we say petroleum as liquid gold? Because each means no crude petroleum is wasted. Everything is utilized for some or the other purpose. Okay. See, liquid petroleum is known as crude oil. That is, it is used for making petrol, diesel, kerosene, isn't it? Etc. And now, petroleum in the gaseous state, it is known as natural gas. And what else? So, while liquid gold, because no part of crude petroleum is wasted, therefore petroleum is known as liquid gold. Now, petroleum in the liquid state, they are used as petrol, diesel, kerosene. Petroleum in the gaseous state, they are used as natural gas. And petroleum in the semi-solid to solid state, they are used as, or they are said as asphalt. Okay. Asphalt, tar, pitch, etc. So, this was petroleum, all about petroleum. And where are they found? In which rocks are this petroleum found? They are also found in the sedimentary rocks. Did you remember I said that coal is also found in the sedimentary rocks? Similarly, petroleum is also found in the sedimentary rocks. Okay. Now, let's move on to the advantages and disadvantages of coal. If you have not watched part 1 of chapter Conventional Sources of Energy, then please do watch it. Because in that video, I have explained all about coal. Now, what are the advantages and disadvantages of petroleum? Advantage of petroleum is that it has high density, or you can also say high calorific value. Okay, because you can say that 1 kg of petroleum can give 10,000 kilocalorie. Okay, 1 kg of petroleum, only 1 kg can give 10,000 kilocalorie of heat energy. Okay. Now, what's the second advantage? Petroleum, as it's a liquid, it can be transported through pipes. So, the transportation is easy. Transported through pipes. It can be transported through pipes. Okay. Now, what's the third advantage of petroleum? It's that it acts as a source of energy for a vast area. It means that petroleum can be used as a source of energy in many fields. Let's see one by one. First, they can be used as fuel, isn't it? we all use petrol, diesel as fuel for our automobiles. Okay, now what's the second one? They are used after refining. After refining, we get synthetic rubber. Synthetic rubber. They are also used in cosmetics and many other area like fiber, PVC, petrol, and many more. Okay, what's the third one? They are also used for power generation. Power generation. Okay, so these were some advantages of petroleum. Now let's move on to the disadvantages of petroleum. What's the first disadvantage of petroleum? The first and foremost disadvantage of petroleum is that it is a non-renewable source of energy. Therefore, the petroleum content that we have is decreasing day by day because the demand for petroleum or the need for petroleum is increasing day by day. Okay, so what is it? The resource, petroleum resource, is depleting. Okay, what's the second one? By we get energy from petroleum by burning it, but what happens by burning it? We cause pollution and greenhouse gases are released. Greenhouse gases are released, which aids to global warming. Okay, now what's the third one? It is costly. Why it is costly? A product becomes costly when it is in high demand, but its availability is low. So it's the same reason with petroleum also. It is costly because it is in high demand, but it is found or the resources are depleting. Therefore, very less resource of petroleum is left behind. What's the fourth one? It is highly inflammable. Highly inflammable. Now, what does it mean? That is, it is highly inflammable. It means that it can catch fire very easily. Therefore, we should be very careful while handling with petroleum. While the transportation also, they are very careful about this property because it is highly inflammable. They are protected and then transported. Okay. Now, what's the fifth one? Oil spills. See, most of the time we find that this petroleum are mined from the water resources, isn't it? Mainly from oceans and seas. For example, in India itself, we have the Mumbai High Oil Refinery, or we can say simply, we get petroleum from the Arabian Sea. Okay, so it's an example, isn't it, that petroleum is mined from the water resources, mainly oceans and sea. Now, while we are taking out petroleum, if the petroleum spills or leaks from the pipe, then what happens? Oil spill happens. That is, the petroleum gets distributed in the water also, as a result of which water gets polluted, and this is known as oil spills. This oil spill can cause the death of marine animals, and also it will also pollute water. So it's one of the very important disadvantage of petroleum. Okay, so these were some advantages and disadvantages of petroleum. Now let's move on to the next part, and that is, we are going to discuss about oil refineries. What oil refineries. Oil refineries are places from which, or they are places where these petroleum that are mined from the earth's crust are refined so that they can be used by us. Okay. We will learn them in depth now. The various oil refineries that are found in India, etc. and etc. Okay. So, what is oil refinery? It's the place where the petroleum, the crude oil, what does it mean? I have several times used this word here, isn't it? Crude oil, that is the oil that we get directly without any refining or processing. Okay, it's the first original product that we get from the earth's crust. So the crude oil cannot be directly used for purposes. Therefore, they are refined and processed. The place where this refining and processing is done is known as oil refinery. Oil refinery. Okay. Now, what happens is that in India, most of the refineries are under public sector. Okay. Only very few are under private sector. So, which is the first oil refinery that started privately or they are working in private sector? And that is Reliance Petroleum Limited. Reliance Petroleum Limited. Where is it located? It is located at Jamnagar in Gujarat. See, after refining, there are various refinery steps. The light refineries are that we get after refining crude oil are like what we can say, light distillates. Okay, they are like gasoline, LPG, etc. are the light distillates. And what about the middle distillates? They are like diesel and kerosene. And the heavy distillates are and the rest is the heavy ends. Okay. Now, what else? So these were about oil refineries. Now, most of the refinery are located near the coast itself. Do you know what's the reason behind it? Why most of the refinery are located near the place where we get that, where we get the petroleum? The reason is that, as I have already said, petroleum is highly inflammable. Therefore, to avoid taking the risk of transporting petroleum throughout the country or through the country, they set up the refineries near the place where it is mined, so that there will be not much risk of transporting petroleum because it will be nearer, isn't it? And also to reduce the cost of transportation. So these were the two reasons why most of the refineries are located near the coast or near the place where the petroleum is mined. So if a question comes, then you have to write this answer. Okay. Now, distribution. That is, which are the places in India where petroleum is distributed? The first one is the Assam-Arakan belt. Assam-Arakan belt. In this belt, we can find places where we can get the petroleum. Okay, it's located in the northeast region of India. This was the first one. Second is the Gujarat Cambay belt. It's located in the western part of India, Gujarat Kambay Belt, and the third one is the Mumbai High. Okay, so it's, you all know, near, it's in Maharashtra, or Mumbai High particularly is in the Arabian Sea near Mumbai. Okay, so now, basing on the importance of oil refineries, we are gonna study three oil refineries here. The first one is Mumbai High. Mumbai High. It is 176 kilometer from Mumbai, that is in the Arabian Sea. It's located 176 kilometer far away from Mumbai in the Arabian Sea, and it's known as Mumbai High. Now, do you know why this particular name is given? That is why it's named so. Why Mumbai High is called so? Because here the oil reserve is taken out from a great depth than any other mining places. Therefore, Mumbai High is named so. Okay. It means the height of the synclined rock from which the oil is taken out, it's very high than any other places. Now, do you know by using which machine is this oil taken out? It's taken out by using a automatically propelled jack known as Sagar Samrat. Okay. In Mumbai High, we have 5 crore tons of oil. Okay, so just imagine how much oil or petroleum is reserved in this place, Mumbai High. How much? 5 crore tons of oil. Okay, so it was the first one. The second one is the oil fields of the eastern region. Oil fields of eastern region. Here in the oil fields of eastern region, we can find the biggest oil field, and that is Digboi. Digboi in Lakhimpur of Upper Assam. Okay. It's present in Digboi oil refinery is present in Lakhimpur of Upper Assam. So first we discussed about Mumbai High. The second is the oil fields of eastern region. Now we are going to discuss about the oil fields of western region. Here, apart from the Kambay Basin, I said that there is a Kambay Belt, isn't it? Gujarat Kambay Belt. Apart from that, we also have various other reserves in Gujarat itself, that is in places like Kalol and Koyali, Kosamba, Navgaon, etc. In all these places found in Gujarat, there are still more reserves of petroleum. Okay, so here we discussed all about petroleum, that is, what is petroleum, from which two words petroleum comes, that is petra and oleum, its advantages, disadvantages, various oil refineries. The oldest oil refinery is, sorry, the biggest oil refinery is Digboi, present in Lakhimpur of Upper Assam. So it was all about petroleum. Thank you for watching till the end, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Bye.